The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Hello everyone, how are you today? I'm Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to talk about gastritis. Gastritis is different. It's different from heartburn, it's different from indigestion. We have already seen videos on those topics. Gastritis occurs when the lining of the stomach becomes inflamed or swollen. Indigestion is a feeling of fullness in the upper part of abdomen, and heartburn is when the acid or stomach contents come up in your food pipe. So gastritis is the inflammation or the swelling, abrasion on the walls of the stomach, right? That is gastritis. Now gastritis can actually last for a very short times, which is called acute gastritis, and it may also linger for months to years, which is chronic gastritis. So you need to understand what can cause this swelling or inflammation on the lining of the stomach. The most important causes of gastritis, number one cause is medicines. Yes, any painkiller, aspirin, ibuprofen, naproxen, NSAIDs or any similar drug can cause gastritis. Many other medicines can cause gastritis, including Ayurvedic medicines, including other allied medicines, allopathic as well. Heavy alcohol drinking can cause acute or chronic gastritis. Then infection of the stomach with a bacteria called H. pylori, Helicobacter pylori, can cause gastritis. These are the most common reasons for gastritis. The less common reasons are like something called as pernicious anemia, which is an autoimmune disease which leads to B12 deficiencies. Then backflow of the stomach backflow of bile from the liver into the stomach can lead to gastritis. Then cocaine abuse, drugs, taking any kind of recreational drugs can lead to gastritis. Eating or drinking, you know, corrosive substances, caustic substances, just like a poison, will definitely lead to gastritis. Extreme stress can also lead to gastritis, quite frankly. And even a viral infection like herpes simplex virus, cytomegalovirus, some kind of viruses can actually lead to gastritis. More often, these people will have a weak immune system. Therefore, they will have this problem. Then there can be trauma or a severe sudden illness with like a major surgery, kidney failure, or being placed on a breathing machine can also lead to gastritis. So there are so many reasons why you can have gastritis, but you need to understand what will happen when you have gastritis. Obviously the lining of the stomach is inflamed or swollen, but what will it lead to? See, many people do not have any symptoms during gastritis, but many will have loss of appetite, nausea, vomiting, or pain in the upper part of the belly or abdomen. They can have these kind of symptoms, right? But if you have feeling of fullness, that is indigestion, not gastritis. Then gastritis can also cause bleeding. So if gastritis causing bleeding from the lining of stomach, you can have black stools, because the blood gets mixed up with your stools and then the stools become black, tarry. So if you have black stools, you should be alert. Then if you have blood in your vomit or coffee ground color material in your vomit, then you should be alert of bleeding inside, right? Then liver functions, coagulation profile, many tests have to be done. Obviously when it comes, blood tests are the basic thing which needs to be done, right? And anemia, low blood for hemoglobin, low blood counts, coagulation profile, liver function, kidney function, many tests are done. Then examination is done on the stomach from the above and from the inside. Endoscopy should be done to see where it is actually gastritis, where is it present, and is there any ulcer, or if there is something, then biopsy can be taken, right? Then H. pylori testing can be done, which can be done by breath test or IgM, IgG levels of H. pylori can be done. Even stool test can be done for that matter. Then stool test is done to check for small amount of blood in the stools, which may be a sign of bleeding in the stomach. Stool for occult blood is also done. Hemoglobin is tracked. So all these things are important. Then what is the treatment? See, treatment will depend upon what is causing gastritis. Obviously, sometimes, most of the times, you know, as the cause goes away, your gastritis will heal, right? So you may need to stop taking the antacid, painkillers, all the things, stop taking alcohol, even smoking can cause gastritis, stress can cause gas. So you have to take care of all these things, right? Obviously, lifestyle changes is the priority thing. Eat small frequent meals, drink a lot of water, take rest, do exercise, sleep on time, proper sleep schedule is important. So all the things you have to do. But if things don't work with all these primary, changes, then you can switch on to some over-the-counter medicines, prescription medicines for gastritis, like antacids or H2 blockers or proton pump inhibitors. You can take antacids which neutralize the acid. Proton pump inhibitors, H2 blockers, they reduce the amount of acid in your stomach, because wherever there is inflammation, any acid which is touching that inflamed part will lead to pain, which lead to problem, right? So that's why antacids can be taken for some period of time, limited period of time. And if you have, for that matter, an H. pylori infection, then antibiotics will be needed to treat that chronic gastritis which is caused by H. pylori, because H. pylori usually leads to chronic gastritis. So that's how you take care of gastritis. But remember, if you have gastritis and blood loss and a lot of weight loss along with it, it can lead to cancer. It can be a sign of cancer. So if you have pain in the upper part of the abdomen, which is not going away, if you have black tiry stools, any kind of blood in vomiting or coffee ground color like substance in vomiting, then go to a doctor, get evaluated. Best doctor is gastroenterologist. Prevention, see, long-term use of any of these substances which can irritate your stomach, like any anti-inflammatory drug, any painkiller or alcohol, can cause this problem. So you need to take care of this lifestyle changes as soon as possible. So this is all about gastritis. It's different from indigestion, heartburn and GERD. Do watch videos on those topics as well on my channel. Do share this knowledge with a colleague, with somebody, with a friend, so that you remember it well. I am Dr. Paramjeet. You're watching Dr. Education. Stay connected and stay healthy.